Motor Week is made possible by Rock Auto, Tire Rack, and Die Hard.
Hello and welcome to Motor Week 88. We're glad to have you with us. It's no secret that automakers back racing teams because a winning image sells more cars. Chevrolet has successfully backed NASCAR teams for years and is now making a big push in the IMSA GTU class. To celebrate this, Chevy has introduced a special street version of their Beretta race car. It's the front drive successor to GM's long line of race-bred rear drivers that includes the Monte Carlo SS and Buick's fire-breathing Grand National. But does the Beretta GTU have what it takes to stand alongside its predecessors? The Beretta GTU must deal with more than the reputation of previous GM muscle cars. It must also contend with the fast-growing renown of its race car cousin. The Beretta racer started its competition life in IMSA's GTU series by winning the Miami Grand Prix and has since gone on to build an impressive record. This will lead many prospective Chevy buyers to expect a similarly exciting car in the Beretta GTU. Unlike the Monte Carlo SS, which is a specific model, however, the GTU is an optional appearance package which is added to a red, white, or black Beretta GT. Coach Builder Cars and Concepts has done a remarkable job of designing racy add-ons that don't make the normally shark-like Beretta look like Moby Dick. The front end drops menacingly thanks to a deep, aggressive chin spoiler. A body color grille and wide hood bulge contribute to the non-standard look. The body extensions continue in an uninterrupted rearward flow with flared wheel arches and side skirts. The hefty tail wraps it all up with a large race-style spoiler and prominent lower body extensions. The racing background is reinforced by fat Goodyear Eagles mounted on special 16-inch aluminum wheels. As add-ons go, it's the best we've seen. At $2,500, it's also expensive, so you pay for quality. The GT drivetrain means that power comes from Chevy's tried-and-true 2.8-liter V6. Making 130 horsepower and 160 pound-feet of torque, it's adequate for most driving, but hardly on a par with other race-derived Chevys like the IROC Camaro. It pulls the GTU from 0 to 60 in 9.2 seconds. A quarter mile takes 17 seconds at 81 miles per hour, quite respectable by family car standards. The rubbery 5-speed manual shifter in our test car discouraged quicker trips through the gears. This same unit performed much better in the last Beretta GT we tested. As long as you're willing to accept that this is simply a nicer Beretta GT, you're fine. If you're looking for 6-second 0 to 60 times, you'd best look elsewhere. That's not to say that the GTU isn't capable. The Z51 suspension retains and improves upon the crisp handling that endeared us to the GT and exhibits much less body roll than its plainer sibling. The steering has better feel than previous Berettas, but is still a bit overboosted for our taste. More road feel would go a long way towards improving driver confidence. But the grip is there, even if you can't feel it. The GTU glues itself to the road in high-speed maneuvers and refuses to let go. Braking is much improved over our last Beretta, with average stops of 121 feet from 60 miles per hour. Pedal fade is minimal and front lockup has disappeared. Straight, smooth stops are now the norm. With all the exterior flash, you'd expect a special edition interior as well. Not so. The Beretta GTU uses the custom trim package from the GT. Only a badge on the dashboard tells you that you're in a special car. Seating consists of the same manually adjustable buckets found in the GT, complete with seat bottom tilt. We liked them then, and we like them now. The dash is one of GM's better recent designs. It's handsome and functional, with a grade of plastic that equals that found in some Japanese competitors. Our test car came with the Beretta's optional digital gauge package. We recommend sticking with the cleaner analog gauges instead. Heat and stereo controls are typical Beretta, clear and simple. Their under-dash pod position does force you to reach for them, however. The rear seat offers better legroom than most Oriental competitors, but headroom is a bit tight. Shoulder belts are now standard for rear seat passengers. One of our biggest complaints about the Beretta GT naturally applies to the GTU. The small opening and intruding power deck lid release ruins an otherwise excellent trunk. EPA mileage estimates for the GTU's platform are 19 city and 29 highway. Our mixed test loop returned a disappointing 19 miles per gallon. The small gas tank cuts the car's range even further. Interior sound levels for our GTU was a low 66 decibels at 55. The same, unfortunately, cannot be said for the price. Once you add the GTU's $2,500 price to a loaded GT, you get a hefty $14,649 price tag. This puts the Beretta GTU at a disadvantage when compared to one logical competitor, the limited production Chrysler Shelby CSX. The CSX offers all the exterior goodies at a lower price and is a genuine performance car to boot. On our safety check, the Beretta GTU passes with rear shoulder belts, 5 mph bumpers, and radial tires. It lacks front passive restraints and anti-lock brakes. Hits start with the GTU package's tastefully flashy approach to add-ons. We also like the solid handling, heavier steering feel, and improved brakes. Misses include the high price, mild drivetrain, poor gas mileage on our car, and tight trunk opening. Most elements are already in place to turn the Beretta GTU into a superior road machine. Chevy only needs to fit a bit more power under that traffic-stopping skin to turn the spirit of this sharp little front driver into a machine that's truly worthy of its racing.